Hey folks, so it's been a while since I've made a video. Life's been, well, I guess, treating us a little bit like a baby treats a diaper the last month or so. But I'm hoping now that's coming to an end. Things are starting to settle and return to normal in the house, and I've been getting a bit more time here at the bench. A few weeks ago, I was planning, I was hoping anyway, that I was going to be getting all kinds of time at the bench, but then things changed, and that wasn't possible. But now, like I said, things are returning to the new normal, I guess, and I'm hoping that I can spend more time in here. I've been averaging the last couple of days about an hour or so, sometimes two, here at the bench, so that's an improvement, considering I was only managing 5 or 10 minutes every couple of days before that, and yeah, that wasn't working. So anyway, so this kit is the Panzer 4C from Dragon, the super kit, and it was a gift from Brighton Paul in the UK. Thank you, Paul. I've already thanked him a bunch of times, but it was such a generous gift, I don't think there's enough times I could actually say thank you for this kit, because it is one of my very favorite kits to build. I built this kit twice before, and it's one of my very favorite things to build. Unfortunately, this time I'm not able to put as much attention to detail on it that I have in the previous times that I've built this thing, simply because I don't have the visual acuity that I once did. My eyes are getting old, and so am I, and so I'm not able to do the photo etch anymore. And I've done a little bit on it, enough to know that there's no point in doing anymore. I'm just gonna screw it up even worse than it already is. You know, there's some things on here that it's unavoidable, you have to do the photo etch because they don't have a plastic option. So you know, I went with it anyway. But for the most part, if I'm given the option to use styrene, I use styrene. I just don't have that option anymore. My days of super detailing kits are long behind me, I think. I was given the choice of fixing my eyes there back early last year, and we were all set up to get it done, and then the pandemic hit, and I lost my opportunity to get them fixed. And now I've been told it's too late, and there's nothing that can be done, so we got a dog instead. And I gotta say, the dog was a better choice, because I'm a happier man. Much happier than I would be with better eyes. So, yeah, I think it was the better choice. You know, if I'm eventually not able to build models anymore because I can't see anymore, at least I still have a dog. And, yeah, I'm sorry, that's makes up for it. I like dogs better than I like the hobby, so. But anyway, but for now, I'm still able to peck away at this. I'm just not at the level of detail or accuracy or even quality that I once was able to muster. So, but I do it again. It's funny. I'll sit here and peck away at this thing, and then I'll take pictures of it and go to post them on Facebook and go, oh, shit, I screwed that up. Oh, shit, I screwed that up. Oh, look at that. Oh, God, that looks like awful. Because I can't see it when I'm working on it, but I can see it in the photos because the photos are larger than the real thing. So, but, yeah. So I've been taking more pictures of the thing as I'm working so I can see what I'm working on, because I can't see it when I'm working on it. That didn't make much sense, but that's actually what I've been doing. Yeah, so, but as kits go, you know, I love this kit. It is one of my favorite kits, like I mentioned. And I was hoping that I'd be able to throw on some workable tracks to go with the workable suspension with this thing, but that didn't happen. I don't have any more Fru model tracks. They're all used up on builds that are still on my shelf. I found these in my stash, but I don't know what the hell they're from. They're Panzer IV tracks, but they would never fit on a Panzer IV. Not any Panzer IV I'd ever know of. They're way too short. They're like 2 centimeters too short. I have no idea where I got these from, but they're junk because they don't fit on any kit that I can imagine. So I knocked off the spring from back here. But that's fine because I had every intention of using the magic tracks anyway, because the model is going to be sitting on a cobblestone street, so it doesn't actually need workable tracks and workable suspension. It'll just be sitting on a flat street, so it'll be fine just the way it is. The figures for the scene are already done. I have a bunch of period appropriate Panzer IV or Panzer crew that will work with this. The figure that came with the R35 that's going to go with this scene, I'm not sure if I'm going to use him yet. If I am, unfortunately, he'll be expired. He'll be dead. So I have to remodel him so that he is posed differently, because he's a little bit too alive in the pose that he's in now, and I can't have that. He's not going to do a zombie guy. So he'll be, if it does get used, he'll be repurposed, reposed. I may just leave the R35, you know, abandoned and sitting there without the crew. I haven't decided yet completely. Depends on, I guess, yeah, it really depends on how well the remodeling goes of the Panzer IV or the R35 crewman goes. If that goes to pot, then I won't use them. So the actual diorama itself, I haven't actually done any work on it at all, other than, you know, going through it in my head on how tall I want it to be, how many floors, and mostly like trying to decide if I actually want to go with the colors that I really want to, because the photos that inspired me were the pharmacy and a hotel that I found in France, and they're really brightly colored, and I really want to paint them that. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to do that. I'm probably still going to, I don't know. I'm still thinking about it though. But either way, the design of the two buildings is definitely the theme that I'm going to go with. Whether or not I'll go with the colors yet, it still remains to be seen. There's a piece of junk in here I just noticed. That's how you break your model. Drop your tools on it. I don't know. Right now, I don't know for sure if I'm going to go with those colors that it comes in, but pretty sure I'm going to go with the design, the architectural design that the style that they're in. It's pretty freaking cool. I like them. So I guess this is more of a video for the sake of making a video, just to let you know I'm still alive and kicking. I'm not dead. I really haven't had any time at all to do any modeling, so I haven't made any real progress on this. It's just been in the last few days I've managed to get some work done on this, and it's about maybe 80% done. I got to put some more details on the turret, and then I got to do the tracks, and that's pretty much it, I guess. I'm probably going to do some stowage. I might do a national flag to go with it, like a swastika that'll put on there. Got to be careful, because if I put that on Facebook right now seems to be going through some kind of shit hemorrhage on national insignia from Germany from the Second World War. I know of two Facebook pages that have been deleted because of it. Actually, one of them was deleted because of the models. It just had like really well done models on it, and they deleted it because they didn't like the models. They were all German tanks and stuff like that. And there weren't any insignia on it that I know of. I can't remember seeing any on there, but it was just really well done German armor, and they deleted it. If that's the case, my Facebook page is at risk, because I have a lot of it on there too. I wouldn't say they're well done, but you know, at least it's all a lot of German armor on there. I even have some German insignia on there that, you know, they might have a shit hemorrhage over. And I know of one Facebook group that was deleted by Facebook because of them posting some German rank insignia and reference material. That was one group, and that was recently. And then Hamilcar Barkus's group was deleted for the same reason, last year, I think it was. So the Facebook group that I know of that was deleted, they, within days, they rebirthed it. So it came back under a new name, and they started rebuilding the group. So the fellows that ran that were pretty good fellows. They're pretty determined on keeping their community alive in spite of the Facebook's appalling behavior. They plan on keep going. So I give them credit for that. It's, you know, Facebook and their ridiculous greed and saturated viewpoints. So if anyone needed a good stoning, it's the people that run Facebook. So anyway, but either way, I'm going to probably do some national insignia on here. And if it gets killed, it gets killed. I don't really give a shit. So anyway, yeah, I guess that's that. What else? Anything else? Bum, bum, bum. No, I can't think of... Oh, yeah, the Facebook group that we're running on, the Warts and All Facebook. The Facebook group build that we're hosting on the Warts and All Facebook group is about to come to an end, mere days away. We extended it by 2 months so that some fellows can get their builds done. I don't know how good that helped them, how much use it was of, to them. It helped me because I managed to get mine done, but I'm thinking that it may not have helped some of the guys that needed it. I don't know how much progress they made. I'm hoping that we see a few finales in that category. There's already a bunch of guys that have finished theirs, but we have to, I guess, see what happens for the last few. So I'm hoping that I'll be able to put together a video showing off their work at the end, and then I'll post that on the group and here on my YouTube channel so everybody can see it. And it's the Eastern Front group build, so it's basically like Barbarossa around that period. So it was actually some pretty cool builds that came out of that. So I was pretty proud of the enthusiasm that went into it. So hopefully I'll have a video up on that. And probably that will be my next video that I post is the finale for that. If not, it'll be another video for this. So this is almost finished. And I'm going to start getting to work on the diorama almost right away as soon as this is done. So anyway, I think that's all I got for this. I can't think of anything else I wanted to say. So you guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.